guys, welcome back to our channel.
In this video, we will tell you what to expect on your AMC MCQ exam day.
So if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. Number 1. Make sure to get enough rest, especially if your exam is in the morning, because the exam is tiring.
During our time, our exam was at 7:30 a.m. and you have to be at the exam site 30 minutes before. So you also have to allot time for travel.
Also, make sure to eat before your exam since the exam is 3.5 hours.
Okay, number 2. Make sure to wear something comfortable, something not too warm nor cold.
The rooms are air-conditioned. However, there are seats that may be directly over the air conditioner.
Also, take note that they check you for any writing, so they may ask you to lift up your sleeves, pull up your pants, and pull down your collar to check your neck.
Number 3. For girls, do not use big hair accessories. Before the exam, they will let you read a set of rules, which included no use of hair accessories around greater than 2 centimeters.
In our experience, they asked us to remove hair clamps while they allowed us to use hair ties. Number 4. Make sure to bring 2 IDs. Your primary ID should include your photograph and signature, while your secondary ID should include your signature.
Acceptable primary IDs are your driver's license, passport, your country or state ID, or your alien identification card, while secondary IDs are your credit, debit, or ATM cards, your social security card, or any of the primary IDs I mentioned before. Number 5. After reading the guidelines, you will need to present your identification cards to the registration, and then a specific locker will be assigned to you.
You will only need to bring your primary ID and the keys to the locker in the examination room. Number 6. We didn't use the bathroom. Although you can go to the bathroom, but your time for the exam is not paused.
You can go to the bathroom after putting your things in your locker. Of course, it's better to go to the bathroom so that you can maximize your time in your exam. Number 7. Eating and drinking is prohibited in the examination room. However, if you need to drink your medicine, you will need to go out and be accompanied by your proctor.
Number 8. On your examination desk, they will provide you with a small whiteboard and a marker for your notes and your computations.
Number 9. During the exam, you are being watched because there is a front camera in the computer. Also, if you encounter any problems, you can raise your hand to call your proctor.
Number 10. Before your exam, you will be asked to check your name in the computer. Make sure your name is correct.
After that, you will need to answer a set of trial questions before the actual exam. Number 11. Since Pearson is also a testing site for other exams, don't feel pressured if others finish early.
During our time, there were also a lot of people taking other exams such as English exams and NCLEX for nurses. Number 12, and the most important tip of all, is to pace yourself. Since the computer does not remind you how much time you have left, except when you have only 10 minutes left.
So make sure to manage your time wisely and to check how much time you have left from time to time.
Also, what we did was, since we have a total of 150 items, we split it into 3, and then since we have 210 minutes, we allotted 70 minutes per 50 items. That's it guys, thank you for watching our video.
If you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.
Bye!